Hello. Good afternoon. My name is Paolo. Thanks for coming. I'm a photographer from Italy, and before showing you, which I guess you've already seen, but anyway, so you know this video of Antarctica, I wanted to show you sort of what another sort of short movie I made of which sort of is condenses sort of many years of work.
こんにちは、ようこそいらっしゃいました。パオロさんです。イタリア出身の写真家なんですけれども、今見ていただいているのが南極大陸シリーズですね。でこの後に、南極大陸以外にもさまざまなシリーズをお撮りになっていらっしゃるんですが、それをまとめた短い映像をお見せしたいと思います。
Yeah, hang on. Just briefly, so you know, this video, so this movie is about four and a half minutes long. It has some music, and so I'm not going to say anything. Sort of, it's kind of an experience, and yeah. So we're gonna watch it in silence, I guess.
で今からお見せする映像は4分から4分半ぐらいのものなんですけれども、音楽を伴っていて、どっちかといったらその、体験型というか、見て、そのイメージを皆さんの中でこう経験していただくような、なので、音楽もありながら無言でじっくりと見ていただければと思います。一つの作品っていうことですよね。
Both my parents were architects, and I studied architecture. Also, I began studying architecture as a young man. And then, I think I was 22 or 23, I decided that architecture wasn't the thing for me, and I embraced photography.
私は両親がともに建築家なんですね。で、自分も建築をずっと勉強していたんですけれども、22歳かな、22、23の時にどうも自分の進む道では建築ではないということに気づいてから、写真の方に、転向しました。
And for me, photography, sort of my interest in photography was always in a photography sort of which had a relationship with history, sort of with events, world events, and ultimately a humanistic photography, sort of where sort of the man sort of was at the center.
写真を撮るとき、なぜ写真に惹かれていったかというと、写真と歴史を語る上での写真という、存在ですねの関係性、それから社会を映す鏡としての写真、最終的にはその人を映す鏡としての写真ということに興味を持っています。
And this has led me on a path, sort of, for the last 30 years, roughly, sort of which you have seen sort of a very sort of condensed and sort of pale sort of in this video.
そしてここ30年間写真を撮ってきたわけですけれども、今ご覧いただいた映像がまさにその30年間のを振り返った映像になります。
Some of the ideas that sort of that inform my work sort of were to I guess I never really thought sort of that photography or my photography sort of could change sort of things sort of necessarily, so even though obviously sort of it changed me very much.
その自分の写真が世の中を変えられるとは思ってないけれども。
But I very much believed in the idea and still believe in the idea sort of a photography sort of which.You know, the idea of the photographer witness, sort of, which creates records of things that happen, you know, of things that man does to man, sort of, and that these records, sort of, even though they might not have an immediate cause and effect, sort of, nonetheless they exist, and they can be, you know, they become parts of our memory, part of our historical memory. They can be accessed sort of later on.
でもその写真を撮ることで、そこで何か起きたことをウィットネスですね、記録し、その記録が残ることで、それを見ること、過去に起きたことをにアクセスできる人がいて、でそれがまあ歴史の一部、それから大きな意味での記録に一部になれる。ということは信じていますと。
They can be accessed for historical purposes or for accountability purposes. The classic example sort of is here, sort of is if a revisionist historian sort of, you know, comes along 70 years later and says, you know, the concentration camps and, you know, in Europe didn't exist. Sort of, you know, we have amongst other sort of proofs, but also photographic proof.That they did. So it's really this idea sort of creating documents.
で、まあ、その写真へのアクセスを考えたときに、まあ、歴史的に後で振り返ったり、まあ、証拠写真として、例えば70年前に強制収容所があったっていうことはもちろんテキストでも分かるけれども、それが写真で残ることでやっぱりその証拠性、歴史性っていうものが強まる。で、まあ、そういう力が写真にはあると思って日々写真を撮っています。
Another idea that has informed my work over the years is that even though sort of I think it might be asking too much, you know, for, you know, two photography sort of to, you know, to change things, I very much believe in the idea of a photograph acting as a seed, So you plant seeds, so, you know, through work, sort of, and these sort of, you know, take on a life of their own, sort of, and they, you know, and they can sort of, you know, they can create a, sort of the conditions for a dialogue with the viewer, and ultimately also maybe sort of, you know, change his or her perspective on certain sort of, issues.
1枚の写真で世の中が変わるとは思わないけれども、でも1枚の写真が種となり、それを、そこからその写真が、まあ、写真を撮るのは写真家ですけれども、撮った写真が一つの種となり、一つの何ていうのかな、生命というかお持ち、それを見た人が、見る人の中で何かが生まれることで、ちょっとずつ世の中が変わっていくということはあるかもしれない。その世の中が変わるきっかけになることはできると思う。
And so after 30 years of doing this type of work, sort of, you know, with these ideas in mind, sort of, a couple of years ago, sort of, I got in contact with, I discovered sort of a program that NASA, the American Space Agency, sort of does in, well, actually worldwide, but specifically sort of in Antarctica.
でそんなことを考えて30年間写真を撮ってきましたけれども、そうしているうちに NASA、 アメリカの NASA から、こうコンタクトというか連絡を受けまして、
and, and I guess as you know, as well, first and foremost, I guess as a father, sort of as a father of two, you know, young daughters, and as a concerned sort of citizen, sort of, it seems to me sort of that we are living in a historical moment, sort of where, you know, the real sort of, you know, issues sort of which you know, transcends all other issues, sort of, is what human activity sort of is doing to the environment, and specifically to climate change. And
で、まあ、南極大陸を撮ってみないかという依頼を受けたんですね。でその時に、まあ、私はあの子供2人の子供を抱える父親でもあり、または、まあ、あの成熟した市民でもある。でそのことを考えた時に、今私たちがいるこの21世紀っていうのは、人間が環境に与える影響で、まあ、地球温暖化が起きているっていう、その歴史的瞬間にいるな、これを撮るのは写真家としても父親としても、また一市民としても、これはやらなきゃいけないことだなと思ったんです。
And maybe now we can start running the Antarctica pictures on them. And so, you know, this, you know, this project I shot in Antarctica sort of, is, you know, a very first step sort of in what I hope sort of will, you know, will be a longer sort of engagement sort of in, you know, in on this theme, on this topic sort of, you know, in the years to come.
でこのシリーズは今後も、続いていく長いプロジェクト、長期プロジェクトなんですけれども、今はその第一段階。
Photographing these pictures were taken from a plane, actually it was an old military plane. It's a submarine hunter. They use a submarine hunter plane because it can fly very low, which is something they need sort of to do the science they do, and also because it has a very extended range.
この写真は飛行機、実は潜水艦を探知するための古い軍事用飛行機で撮られてます。で、潜水艦を探知するためなので、低く低空飛行ができるんですよね。
And I was confronted with a number of problems sort of, in sort of doing this project. The first is how can photography sort of represent climate change? You know, climate change, even though it's vastly accelerated now, as we know, sort of, it's still, you know, it's still very slow. And photography sort of doesn't really sort of, you know, isn't really able sort of to, you know, to capture that sort of so much so that normally sort of, you know, pictures of, you know, which represent climate change sort of are, you know, usually you see, I don't know, like pictures of a monsoon sort of in you know, in Southeast Asia, sort of, you know, with you know, people carrying, you know, there's ways to try and represent something which, you know, which photography isn't really equipped to, you know, to represent.
で、まあ、やり始めてみて様々な問題に直面するんですけれども、その一つがその写真というメディアがどうやったら温暖化を捉えることができるか、まあ、温暖化はこの数十年ですごくこのペースを早めて起きてはいるとはいえ、まだまだそこの言ったゆっくりとした現象ですよね、を写真というメディアで捉えるとはどういうことなのかっていうことです。で、よくありがちなのはその東南アジアのモンスーンとかその温暖化で起きた現象を捉えることもあると思うんですけど、その写真がそういったちょっとスローな温暖化現象みたいなものをどう表彰するかっていう表彰の問題ですよね。
So I took some decisions, some formal decisions, sort of, you know, to find the key, to find the way, sort of visual strategy, sort of, you know, to represent this phenomenon. And the first thing I did, I decided, maybe not so much in the videos. The videos were, you know, I'm talking more about the still images, but I decided to, for the most part, to eliminate the horizon. So to confuse, if you will, in a sense, sort of the viewer, because the scale was so, you know, was so immense, that it became, you know, it became like a metaphysical scale. So, you know, so something which, you know, which had a obviously sort of a physical presence, but also a mental one. And I just couldn't grasp it. So, you know, photography wasn't sort of enough. And so I decided to work backwards, you know, to work in the negative and to eliminate the horizon. That was the first decision.
で、そこで自分が取ったその、まあ、戦略というか方法論は、あんまりその動画ではそうではないんですが、主にそのスティルのイメージの方ではその地平線、それから水平線を、映し込まないということをやりました。で、そうすることで、見る人の視覚に訴えかけるというか、すごく大きいスケールのものを見せるときに水平線がないことで、見る人が、何を見てるのかわからない。でもそのことで人を考えさせることで今見てるものは何なんだっていうことで、こう一個メタのレベルにイメージを持っていくことができると。
And the other decision was to, you know, it's just something I felt sort of when I was, you know, when I was flying, sort of, is that, you know, these landscapes sort of were so incredibly sort of sublime really in the sort of in a sacred sense, sort of I would say, that I thought, okay, so maybe let's try and use sort of beauty, sort of the idea of beauty, sort of, you know, which is obviously so much part of the human experience, sort of, and you know, and has helped, you know, through the centuries, you know, to express sense and meaning, sort of. So let's use beauty, sort of, and specifically the, in this case, the fragility of beauty, to try sort of and connect sort of with the viewer.
で、まあ、飛行機から、見る南極大陸のイメージは非常にこう崇高なものがあったんですね。ですので、まあ、2つ目の、ビジュアル的戦略としてはそのビューティー、美しさっていうのを一つの鍵にしようと思いました。で、今回に関してはその儚い美しさを、その見る人が見る人とその写真の関係の、よりどころにしようと。
And it's this idea that I've always had in my work, really, sort of, you know, that the photographer sort of, you know, provides, you know, some ideas, sort of, you know, his point of view, but then the photograph is finished, is closed, if you will, sort of, only sort of when it is looked at by the viewer, each time in a different way. So, you know, I call them sort of unfinished pictures, you know, pictures which you know, contain sort of my, you know, contain sort of a relationship with reality, with the real. So they contain my opinions, my sometimes my frustrations, my, you know, whatever it is that I feel sort of in front of a given situation. But each time, sort of, you know, they are closed or finished sort of by, you know, by the viewer. So because intrinsic, you know, it's the idea of a conversation, sort of using photography as a conversation with the viewer, with the other, so somebody that I might not know, so, you know, but who will maybe look at my work and that might trigger sort of something. Sorry.
でよく写真はその撮る写真家アーティストの視線を、投影しているとか、その写真家にはメッセージがあるとかって言いますけど、まあ、私が考える写真っていうのは、まあ、写真を撮るとのできたこのプリントはあくまでアンフィニッシュ、未完成なんで、それを見る人がいて、見る人がその写真とある意味対話、そこ見る人と作品の間に何かこう対話であったり、まあ、感情でもいいんですけど、それが生まれて、完成すると、作品は完成すると。なので見る人は例えば見る時間も場所も違えば、見る人の持ってる感性もそれから価値観も違う。なので写真はあくまでその人の見る人との関係性を喚起するもの、そして作品と見る人の間に何かが立ち上がる、それを対話、カンバセーションというふうにおっしゃいましたけど、っていうのが写真、私の写真じゃないかなと。
Thank you, Yuki. Yeah, so in a nutshell, sort of, you know, this is what I do, sort of, and if anybody has any questions, so don't be shy.
まあ、そんなことを思って写真を撮っています。
Mr. IT Man, for example.
まあそれが簡単な自分の作品のプレゼンテーションなんですが、皆さんの中から、今の話を聞いて、または作品を見てみて、ご感想、それから質問あったら挙手でお願いします。
Yeah, it's not that, the room is not that big. So you have a question.
Yeah, so the question I had earlier that jumped to my mind immediately is, you know, how do you find yourself in these positions to take photographs, especially in such a dangerous situation?
Yeah, well, I mean, that's just, you know, photographers always joke about writers, journalists, you know, that they can write from, you know, their pieces from hotel rooms. And we can sort of, you know, so, you know,
as a photographer, you
need to, you know, you need to be there, and there is you know, there's a myriad sort of, you know, situations, sort of, you know, but you know, the Latin sort of, you know, expression would be conditio sine qua non. So, you know, it's the condition, it's the initial condition. So you have to be in front sort of you know, of what is going on. So you know, this very famous photographer Robert Capa, who also was the founder of the agency of which I am a part of, called Magnum. So you know, famously used to say, if your pictures aren't good enough, it's because you're not close enough. Sorry, yes.
That's great.
I'm not sure this works, but try.
Thank you. ご質問はまず、あの写真をどうやって撮ってるんだろうって、あそこにもし自分がいるんだとしたらかなり危ないシチュエーションもあると思うんですけど、一体どうやって写真を撮ってるんですかっていうご質問でした。でよくその写真家の間でのこう内輪ジョークというか、ジャーナリストは部屋で記事を書けるけど写真家は外に出ないと仕事にならないよねっていう話があって、 で、まあ、もちろん外に出るにはいろんな危険な場面もあるし、いろんなクリアしなきゃいけないこともあるんだけども、そのマグナムを立ち上げたメンバーの一人でロバート・キャパは、もし写真が良くないとしたら、それはきっと、写真からの距離が近くないからだ、写真からの距離が遠すぎるから写真がいいものになってないって言ってるんですって。それだけ写真家はいつもフロントにいなきゃいけないって。
And of course, he meant it in a physical sense, like you have to be as close as possible, you have to be close, but also in an emotional sense, sort of, you know, close to the, you know, emotionally close, so, you know, or empathically or empathetically, I don't know how you say this in English, you know, you know, with empathy, so, you know, towards the subject. So there is, you know, there's different degrees of closeness, sort of in different.
もちろんそのキャパはその物理的な距離のことを言ってるかもしれないですけども、でも写真家として写真を撮るときはそのメンタルの距離っていうのもありますよね。その被写体に対してどれだけ感情輸入できてるかとか、被写体に対しての思いという距離。
But yes, I mean to conclude, there is an element obviously of sometimes of danger. So I know sort of many photographers who lost their lives or were injured. I was injured. So it's part of the equation, I guess.
で、まあ、そうやっていい写真を撮るために、リスクを伴うということはある。そうやっていい写真を撮ろうとする中で怪我をして、まあ、私自身も怪我したことありますけど、命を落とす写真家もいると、まあ、それはそのジャーナリスティックな写真を撮る上での、まあ、パッケージですよね。
Are you typically on site for a scheduled amount of time or is it until you get the
It depends. So it depends. When I was young, I keep telling my assistant here in who's supposed to be here, but he is okay. These days, so you know, as a young man, as a young photographer, so I had the luxury of time, and you know, I felt I was very poor. And I didn't have money, and then you know, nobody assigned me, and nobody knew, and But actually, in retrospect, sort of that was the most sort of creative period of my life, now sort of I'm just full of commitments. So you're a father, you need to make money. So you work on assignment. So there's clients. Ideally, sort of I would stay sort of as long as it takes. In reality, it's not always like that, and actually less and less so.
ご質問は、写真を撮るときにその期間を決めて、写真を撮るのか、それかいい写真が撮れるまでずっと滞在するんですかっていう質問でした。ケースバイケースなんですけど、若いとき。は実際はお金もない仕事もない自分はなんてこう惨めなんだと思ってたんですけど、今振り返ってみると当時はその時間という資産があったなと思います。でその時が実は一番クリエイティブな時間だったかなとも思う。で今となっては子供もいるし家庭もあるし、それからまあクライアントの、もあるので、撮りたいまで撮れるってことはあんまりないんですね。
Of course, growing older and you have more experience, so I guess I'm faster sort of in my sort of decision making, my visual sort of decision making process, and I eliminate sort of things. It's like in chess, I play chess sort of. With experience, it's like you kind of eliminate the mediocre moves and. So there is something to be said about experience, sort of. But I reflect a lot, sort of, on the fact that there's just less and less time, sort of, to do things.
とはいえ、まあ、経験値がありますから、昔よりはその判断も早いし、同じ絵を撮るのにもっと早く撮れるっていうことはあると思う。 まあ、とはいえその、まあ、昔は時間があった、今はその物を取るっていうことに対して、使いたいだけの時間が使えないっていう現実は感じていますと。
One more question.
まあ、別の、パウロさんの写真を見せていただいたんですけども、1点だけ、モノクロとカラーでモノクロの方が多いんですけども、先ほどの最初のビデオで見せていただいた通り、相手の歓喜を促すそういう写真でそういうモノクロの写真が多いんでしょうか、それともマグナムのに所属していらっしゃるから多いのか、まあ、ちょっとどういう考えでとおっしゃっているかこの際教えていただけたらすごく助かります。
So I've seen other works of yours. I see black and white and color both, but it seems like you do more black and white. Is that because you believe that it creates more dialogue with the viewer that way? Or is this because of the Magnum's policy?
Thank you. That's a good question. I see myself more as a black and white photographer. There is several reasons for this. Sort of, the first sort of is that I feel that I'm in the sort of in the tradition sort of, you know, of photographers, you know, whose work I admire. Sort of, you know, who worked sort of in sort of mostly in black and white. So I try sort of, you know, to honor that tradition.
まあ、自分自身は白黒の写真家だなと思ってるんですけども、その理由はいくつかあって、まあ、一つは過去に影響を受けた作家さんがブラック白黒を多く撮っていた。で、まあ、彼らへのオマージュじゃないですけど、敬愛を示す意味で白黒を撮ってると。
Secondly, black and whiteDoes, I think, something which I'm very interested in, photography, sort of, and that is to, by removing sort of an aspect, sort of a portion of the real, it allows pictures to sometimes, it's not easy, but sometimes it happens, it allows them to be both specific,and universal. So it allows photography sort of to become metaphor.
と、同時に白黒の写真っていうのはその現実から一歩ちょっと距離を取って、その起きてる物事、非常にそこで起きてる物事という意味でそのパーソナルと同時に、普遍的ユニバーサルなものを生みやすいという意味で作品を、メタファーにする効果があるのではないかと。
So the picture of a refugee girl, sort of, which we saw, so, you know, and I always think of that image sort of, when I think about this sort of, you know, is the picture of that girl sort of in Lebanon that year, that day, sort of, you know, running away sort of with her mom.You know, it's tied sort of to that moment in time, but it also has an echo sort of, you know, of a condition, sort of, you know, of the condition of being a refugee. So it transcends, so, you know, that moment. So it's specific and universal. And I find that color is too close to the real, to reality, sort of, and that, you know, that.Closeness, you know, that reality sort of, you know, it doesn't allow this to happen.
例えば難民の女の子の写真があるんですけれども、あの写真を見るとそのレバノンでの何月何日にあった出来事っていうその記録的な意味と、あの写真を見ることでその難民の置かれている状況とかっていうそのユニバーサルなメッセージも生まれてくる。でカラーだとその現実に近すぎてその普遍的な部分が、白黒の方が生まれやすいと私は思っています。
Thank you.
後ろの女性の方。
Hello, thank you for your presentation. So just in case I'm asking a question in Japanese, right? So, 前に、パウロさんが、YouTube か何かで、自分のモレスキンの手帳に、こうスケッチとかをしているような映像を見たことがあって、でそれはすごく絵が上手で、いろんなことをこう描いていらしたんですが、でそれは、なんかその写真を撮る上ですごく大事なプロセスなのか、それとも何か書きながら何か考えているのか、取材の前後にそういうことをされるのか、それともやってる最中にされているのか、そのメモとスケッチとその写真のこういう関連性というか、どういうふうな効果が、あるのかを教えていただきたいと思います。
I've seen before on the YouTube that you take drawings on your journals. Beautiful, beautiful drawings, sketches. I'm curious to see your thinking process, whether you make those drawings before the photo taken, after taken, or how does this process of drawing influences your photo?
Thank you. I is a wonderful chef, by the way. I guess they're building something.
They're doing something like a dance performance.
So my drawings, well, they come from my years in, you know, studying architecture. So you know, I guess I, you know, did a lot of practice at the time. And what I used to do sort of in, of course, you know, I come, unlike all of you who are very young, sort of, you know, I come from another era, sort of, you know, no internet, and
no telephone.
Barely telephones, and especially films, film photography.
ドローイングは実は建築時代の名残なんですけど、まあ、私は皆さん今日いらっしゃる方お若いんですけど、インターネットがまだない、それから写真もデジタル前フィルムの時代の人なんですね。
And of course with film you can't see what you shoot. And so I would leave sort of, you know, for a month or 2 months, sort of, you know, go somewhere, you know, with 200-300 rolls of film.You know, to Cambodia or, you know, wherever I would go, sort of, and I didn't have the opportunity to see, you know, to see what I did. And so I got into the habit and the practice sort of like kind of a discipline, sort of every night when I would go back to wherever I was sleeping, I would make drawings, so quick sketches of the pictures that I thought were good, of the ones that I took that day, to, you know, to create a memory, sort of, but also, you know, to help me sort of, you know, a little bit as a storyboard, sort of, you know, so you know, throughout the, you know, the weeks or month, you know, or whatever it was that I was away, sort of, I would create this, you know, this visual memory, sort of, you know, on paper, sort of, you know, of what I was doing. And it was very interesting because when I then came back home and developed all my films, sort of, you know, there was a great sort of correspondence between sort of the initial drawing or what I remembered, sort of, and the image which I then ended up selecting.
でフィルムってどういうことかというと、1ヶ月とか2ヶ月とか撮影の旅に出るじゃないですか。それがカンボジアであろうとかであろうと、でフィルムに撮ったものってすぐ見えないんですよね、現像するまで。なのでその当時のプラクティスとして、夜寝る前に今日撮った写真はどういう最後絵になるかなって、こう視覚化するっていう実践をしてたんですね。で、まあ、それが一つの1ヶ月分 そのビジュアルメモリーというか絵コンテみたいなものなんですけど、面白いのが実際に写真を現像してみた時の絵と自分がドローイングしてみた時の絵っていうのは大体一緒っていう。
And then I'll just say the last thing because I feel sort of Hiroshi is getting anxious. I feel the vibe from my back. is that...You know, this idea sort of, you know, of drawing, of paper, of using hands, sort of, you know, is is very much part of my practice. Even today, so you know, like my you know, in my studio, so you know, I make little prints and I cut them, you know, with the papers and use tape and thumbtacks. What do they call it? Yeah. Puntina. You know, it's really this idea, so you know, that there is a difference between the screen, sort of, and you know, and the physical object. And sort of even sort of, you know, in today's world and today's photography, sort of, you know, I try sort of to, you know, to keep that aspect alive in my practice.
その紙と、まあ、鉛筆手を使うっていうのは、まあ、今日も自分の、今日もやってる実践で自分の思考とすごい関係あると思ってます。で実際スタジオでもその紙を切ったりタイピングしたりってことはしていて、で今もう全てがデジタルでスクリーンとカメラさえあれば物事が完成しちゃう中で、なんかこの手触りっていうか物理的なものっていうなんかそんっていうのは今も大事にしていきたいなと思っているプロセスです。
And I thank you for being.
Thank you. いいご質問ありがとうございました。
Thank you.